has been under fire for comparing outrage over executive bonuses to civil rights era lynchings. Tonight, the CEO of a company that got billions of dollars in government bailouts is explaining and apologizing. Investigative reporter Paul Van Osdahl has the story you will only see on Channel 4 Action News. Paul?
Well, Wendy, you may remember AIG. That's the company that got $182 billion in bailout money following the financial crisis. The company later paid top executives millions in bonuses, spurring outrage. Today, AIG's CEO was in our area addressing all that outrage and his eyebrow-raising comments about it. This was the scene after the news broke that the bailed-out AIG had paid its executives more than $100 million in bonuses. Last month, AIG CEO Robert Benmosche was asked about that controversy by the Wall Street Journal. He said the uproar over bonuses was intended to stir public anger, to get everybody out there with their pitchforks and their hangman nooses and all that, sort of like what we did in the Deep South. And I think it was just as bad and just as wrong. Monday, when Benmosche spoke to a group of African-American business leaders in Moon, he did not address the statement directly. But later, I asked him about it.
Why did you compare outrage over bonuses to the lynchings in the South?
I think that what I said already is I regret that reference.
Benmosche said the comment was prompted by concern for his employees' safety.
I was not really referring to bonuses. I was referring to the enormous fear that people of AIG felt because of the public outrage.
He has spent the past several weeks apologizing to employees, board members, and an influential congressman who called on him to resign. Benmosche also explained his remarks to Chester Engineers CEO Robert Ogbede, who hosted him Monday.
We met yesterday, and that was brought up, and he explained it, and I'm very satisfied with what he said.
AIG board member George Miles, former CEO of WQED, also is satisfied with the response.
That statement that he made was a dumb statement. He has admitted to it being a dumb statement. He has apologized to Representative Cummings in person. He's apologized to our employees. As far as I'm concerned, it's in the rearview mirror.
Benmosche is trying to spread the word that AIG paid back its taxpayer bailout money along with $22 billion in interest. He's hoping the uproar over his remarks does not obscure that fact. Live in the newsroom, Paul Van Osdahl, Channel 4 Action News.
All right.